Hello friends. Welcome to Tektalksengineered channel. Today we will see what Droop Characteristics of Generators is. What is its significance and what Droop setting is. Generally two or more generators supply the same bus. These generators in parallel should run in Droop mode. In isochronous mode there is no scope for control of load share of generators. Hence isochronous mode is suitable only for a single generator. Whereas using speed droop setting, load share of two or more generators running in parallel can be controlled. There are different types of droops. First speed droop and second voltage droop. We will discuss speed droop setting in the governor of generator. As we know, the formula for droop is no load speed or frequency minus full load speed upon no load speed. This speed droop characteristics of a generator. We can see with increase in load frequency that is speed of generator decreases. This speed droop characteristics of generator is used to control its load share in parallel operation. Let us discuss with an example. This is a bus. Electric power to this bus is supplied by a number of generators running in parallel. Out of which let's consider two generators here. Also it has feeders to which load is connected. Suppose this bus has load demand of 1000 MVA at frequency 50.05 Hz. Out of which 400 MVA is supplied by these two generators and rest 600 MVA by other generators running in parallel. Generator G1 and generator G2. Generator G1 with max load capacity of 500 MVA is loaded at 50% using 2% droop setting. Reference speed is set at 50.10 Hz. Hence G1 is 50% loaded, delivering 250 MVA load at 50.05 Hz speed, which is bus frequency. Similarly, by setting reference speed at 50.10 Hz, generator G2 with 300 MVA capacity is loaded at 50%, delivering 150 MVA load at 50.05 Hz speed. This is how G1 and G2 deliver 400 MVA power to the bus. Now let's say, we want to load generator G2 at 100% of its capacity, delivering 300 MVA load. So speed reference for G2 is raised to 50.15 Hz from 50.10 Hz. Hence with the new droop setting we can see that G2 is loaded at 100% delivering 300 MVA load at 50.05 Hz frequency, which is bus frequency. Now generator G1 and G2 deliver 250 MVA and 300 MVA load respectively. That means out of 1000 MVA load demand of the bus, 550 MVA is supplied by generator G1 and G2, and rest 450 MVA is supplied by other generators running in parallel. In this way using droop setting, load of generator can be controlled by varying reference speed of droop. From this we can see that, by changing the speed or frequency reference of the generator, load output of that generator is changed and not the speed. Frequency or speed of the generator remains equivalent to bus frequency. In case of two generators, one can run in isochronous mode and other in droop mode. The generator with comparatively less capacity is run in droop mode, and the generator with comparatively high capacity is run in isochronous mode. Because any additional load demand gets shifted on the generator in isochronous mode. Here in the graph we can see, in droop mode there is only one point of load axis where generator and bus frequency match. Whereas in case of isochronous mode, bus frequency can be matched at any load. Hence load of the generator with droop mode can be controlled, not the one with isochronous mode. So guys, this is about speed droop of generators. Hope you like the video. If yes, please hit the like button and comment. For more videos, please subscribe. Thank you.